Hello YouTube, welcome to AutoCrafter. In this video, we will change the sweep controller with higher performance ESC, the Hobbywing 1080, and downgrading the 775 DC motor power rating to 80 watts to prevent ESC damage caused by overloading at full speed. I changed this part because the previous ESC I used caught fire while testing the motor. I don't know the main reason, but I guess it's from a much heavier motor spec for the ESC, and the battery I used also had a high discharge rate at 30C. Even though during the previous testing the car didn't have any load, it was only an engine speed test. But the ESC still burned down, permanently damaged, and even now it still smells bad. Okay, do you want to know how to change the speed controller? Keep watching this video. First, we need to unboxing this Hobbywing 1080 ESC. I already changed the motor connector with 3.5 mm banana connector. This ESC already have program card to set up the ESC according to our driving style and truck chassis configuration. This is little comparison with my previous ESC, the Hobbywing 1060. Besides its technical spec, the new ESC have much better heatsink, better power switch, and longer output cable. I also lowering the motor spec for safety reason to the ESC. The new DC motor has dual bearing on each side, so it rotates much smoother and lasts longer. Old DC motor suffer more difficult to turn by hand. Maybe it's the reason why my previous ESC burned down. Now, we need to disassemble the chassis, because the 775 DC motor located in the inside of V8 engine block. We can start by disassembling the front axle and its suspension system. Disassemble the front suspension system by removing 4 pins on the left springs. Then you can disassemble the steering bell crank by opening a long bolt on its pivot point. Open 6 bolts on the front end of chassis rail to disassemble the 3-channel servo holder. Now disassemble the 12 blades radiator fan by opening 1 bolt on its center point. Then, open the 3 bolts on the top side of crankshaft bearing holder. Now, the V8 cylinder head can be removed and showing its heart, the 775 DC motor. Open the N20 DC motor cover. And take out the pulley of crankshaft. And finally, the 775 DC motor can be disassembled to be changed with new one. Take a double side foam tape and peel off each tape. Then, place it in the center of ESC holder. Peel off again the remaining tape and place the ESC in the center of ESC holder. The ESC is ready to place in the servo holder. Place the ESC to the servo holder with a screw on each side.
replace the power switch to servo holder using double side foam tip. Put the ESC cable below servo cover and connect the cable to the receiver. And last, tidy up the receiver antenna with ESC cable. This is the new 775 DC motor that we'll use on the truck. Put the 775 DC motor to the V8 engine block. Make sure the motor cable going through the engine hole. Now, put the crankshaft pulley through its bearing holder. And put the rubber band on crankshaft pulley. The N20 DC motor already have servo cable, so it doesn't need additional ESC. Put the N20 DC motor on its holder. Now, put the N20 DC motor cover. Then, the VX cylinder head can be assembled to the engine block. Secure the cylinder head with 3 bolts on the crankshaft bearing holder. And then, put the belt tensioner. Now assemble the rubber band to 4 pulley. After that, assemble the 12 blades radiator fan. Take the 3-channel servo holder and put the output cable through the bottom of V8 engine block. Now, tie the output cable with cylinder head so the radiator fan won't strike the cable. After that, connect the motor cable and tidy up the battery cable. And then, secure the cable with 1 long bolt on the servo holder. Now, connect the N20 DC motor cable directly to the receiver. And then, secure the 3-channel servo holder using 6 bolts on the front end of chassis rail. Now, assemble the steering bell crank using 1 long bolt on its pivot point. And then, secure the dual link steering bell crank to the servo horn. Now, the front suspension system can be assembled to the chassis. Secure the front suspension system using 4 pins on the left spring. Now, assemble the steering T-rod with a paper bushing in the inside of it. And last, secure the shock absorber to the shock tower. Before programming the ESC, we need to disconnect the N20 DC motor connector from the receiver. This is to prevent the radiator fan spinning and strike the cable while we set up the ESC. Now, take the program card and put the cable into ESC programming port. Make sure the cable polarity is in the correct position or the program card won't working as it should. After that, put the battery into its connector to power up the ESC. Then, press the power switch and wait the program card to initialize the ESC. We call program the ESC according our driving style and the truck chassis configuration. The most important thing to program the ESC is to set running mode and select the battery type that we use. Then, we also set up drag brake function to be zero since this is not a rock crawling RC truck. Remove the program card cable when finished. Now we can test the function by turning on the transmitter. Make sure the throttle in the neutral zone before switch on the receiver. The ESC should working perfectly. Now, put back the N20 DC motor connector and the truck chassis ready to use.
Well, we finished replacing the speed controller with higher spec ESC. Now, the 775 DC motor can running at full speed with less heat than the ESC. I also programmed the ESC with the crawler type vehicle, so we could have linear torque response at low speed and better vehicle control from the transmitter. This is simple upgrade and preparation before we making the complicated two-speed gearbox, because it's incomplete if you're making the gearbox but get this running right. In the next 3 video, we will be making 2-speed gearbox. Start from gearbox housing, transmission gear set, and gearbox outboard centering gear. Okay, I'm Eddie. Thanks for watching and see you in the next video.